Mary Lou Cooty is a millennial. And that's become a little bit of a dirty word nowadays, right? Snowflakes, entitled, demanding. But she's living through the societal backlash and sticking two fingers up at the negativity surrounding her generation. But what does it mean to be labelled a millennial? What's the root cause of the negativity? And how on earth do we deal with them? Please welcome Mary Lou.
Hi, I'm a millennial, and I'm a monster. I was born in 1992, and therefore a full-blooded millennial. As a result, I am demanding, ambitious, and probably on the verge of a burnout. Who else is a millennial here? You? Monster? No one else? Other monsters in the room? You are a monster as well. No one knows why or how we got this way. For me, it could be my ballet teacher, Sunny, telling me that with hard work, I could become a solo dancer at the Dutch National Ballet. Or my parents. They were the ones praising my shitty four-year-old drawing as a talent for abstract forms. It made me feel invincible, an artist, as if I could become the next Van Gogh. I assure you, I was not. It could also be my math teacher encouraging me to keep on trying. With hard work, repetition, and perseverance, he said I could become a math teacher, even though I'm not able to calculate 7 times 8. I still can't, but now I just use my phone, obviously. As we become older, the monster is already inside of us and we create it ourselves. Picking the broadest study there is because we have no idea what we want. Not choosing a career, but accidentally having one and then thinking, is this it? Sitting in our houses, crying out of despair, because we want so much, everything and nothing, but we're unwilling or unable to actually invest in something. And that's why I'm an entitled narcissist, a millennial, a monster. Just like most of you. So what do we want, millennials? You don't know? I'm gonna give you your answer. You want to eat less meat to help save the planet, and at the same time you take a plane to Bali for a well-deserved yoga retreat. You save the world by doing voluntary work, but you also want to start your own business with locally brewed organic beers. You want to be self-conscious, ban screens, and meditate more, but you need an app to help you meditate. And you watch every Netflix show every other monster is talking about. We want things that are mutually exclusive at the same time. On one evening, we want to work out and eat healthy, have lots of wine with friends, quality time with family, and a Netflix and chill night on the couch. All of that to prevent having FOMO for any of the other options. We binge-watch our way through life, on the verge of a burnout, on the verge of being broke, spending our last money on an overpriced avocado sandwich and then brag about it on Instagram. We want a trophy just for participating, not for winning, because we're not able to handle setbacks. If the Uber is late, we cry. If there's no vegetarian option on the menu, we cry even more. And then we try to find ourselves in countries we've never been before, with money from mom and dad. Once we get back, we try to apply for a job that has a purpose way larger than ourselves. And once we find out that the job doesn't exist, we try to find their purpose in the classes we subscribe to but never attend, the books we buy but don't read, and the festivals we only enjoy with drug-enhanced endorphins. At these festivals, we try to express our unique look by dressing up like everybody else. The same white Reeboks, Patagonia shirt, and jeans with rolled-up legs. You can look around here today for the latest version of that. We are the ultimate me generation. Sounds familiar? This is us, right? This is the monster we talk about. Or is this just people dealing with their environment? Over half of the things I just said are about that. The fact that we live in a digital age means we all have to figure out how to use an iPad, e-reader, MacBook, laptop, and a Google Home without being a total addict. Do all the things I just said really define my generation and only mine? Isn't a millennial just a young person like all other young people before them, trying to figure out what to do with their lives? And as they get older, find their way, accept their job, and the fact that not all their dreams can come true. Doesn't everybody want to give back to the world? Make sure it's still a safe place after our generation is long gone. What about voluntary work? Do people born before 1980 never want to do that? We all want to make something out of our life, regardless of the year we were born in. That's the essence of being human. So let's take a sidestep. In 1948, a famous experiment was carried out by Bertram Fourier about horoscopes. Now, I know that horoscopes are a guilty pleasure for a lot of you, but do you really believe that over 500 million people are going to have the exact same week? Anyways, in this study, people got to do a personality test, and we're all given the exact same results, with things in it like, you are disciplined and self-controlled on the outside, and insecure on the inside. You have the need for other people to admire you. And you have considerable unused capacity that you have not turned to your advantage. I mean, anybody disagreeing with this? Horoscopes aren't exactly personalized. They're just vague statements and generalizations. The same can be said about generations. In this case, millennials. So we're going to stick with the vague statements and generalizations. These are quotes from magazines, and my question to you is, what generation do you think I'm talking about? The now generation has become the me generation. They have trouble making decisions. They rather hike the Himalaya than climb the corporate ladder. They work to live rather than they live to work and value their work-life balance. Still about us, right? Still about the millennials, the monsters. Wrong. All of the things I just said are about Gen Xers, baby boomers, and all the other generations before them. There are complaints of new generations dating back to Greek times. The wise Socrates already said, children nowadays have disrespect for elders and contempt for authority. Generations are usually just old people talking shit on young people. We put name tags on generations and forget that we are all just humans with the same human needs. Do good, be better, be happy, but not at all costs. We should stop defining and grouping people based on the year they were born in. We should liquidate the term millennial. Forget about a generation tag. Millennialism doesn't exist. It's just an image that has been created by the media. The lazy, entitled, narcissistic millennial filling his day taking selfies is fake. There are 50-year-old people doing that and 15-year-olds. In fact, generations are just categories based on opinions about people. People that are basically in the same situation for a while. That's it. That is all there is to it. Put people in a certain situation and I'll guarantee you they're going to behave a certain way. Give them uncertainty, they become uncertain. Give them lots of money and they're going to be spoiled. Give them choices, they have trouble choosing. The most important thing to remember about millennials is that they are people. Young people, slowly getting older. And so they want to be treated as people. So if you're here wondering how you should manage your millennial, just manage them the same way you want to be managed. Provide them with clear feedback on the spot. Give them the freedom to develop themselves and understand that they have a life outside of work. Just like you. And then you will be just fine. Thank you.
Yay! I did it! Happy me!
What an absolute professional. Mary Lou, thank you so much. And
thank
also
you.
Now, you millennials are all right. Thank you.
Well, thanks.